This is truly about safety. It's not about money.
A lot of these tickets are nonsense.
It's all about prevention. You try to deter people from behaving badly.
All new on Wake Up, mixed messages. Should Buffalo City leaders install red light cameras to help cut down on crashes?
Today, the conversation turns up a notch as the Common Council hosts an 11 o'clock public hearing at City Hall.
Now, we are digging deeper into why other cities across the country, including Rochester, have decided to cut the cord on their red light cameras. Merely mention red light cameras.
It's time for people to fight back and to tell the city, stop picking our pockets.
And controversy follows.
And my problem with them is that they actually cause, in my opinion, more traffic collisions and stuff like that.
A lot of these tickets are nonsense.
Larry Krieger was one of the first people in Rochester to get a red light camera ticket. Studies showed the cameras cut crashes at intersections by nearly 21%. Red light violations went down by 44%.
The city will never pull the plug on this because they've gotten used to the easy money.
But they did. The Rochester mayor cut ties with the camera company when its contract ended at the end of 2016. And they're not alone. In 2012, 533 communities in the U.S. used the traffic tool. As of this July, that number dropped to 421, according to the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety.
The whole idea of red light cameras is to be there when the police can't.
The Insurance Institute strongly supports red light cameras. Chuck Farmer, their vice president for research, says cities pull them for a variety of reasons.
There are some groups out there that have organized resistance to the whole idea of automated enforcement. There's also the argument that it's all about money.
Farmer thinks Buffalo is smart to be considering the cams.
Red light running goes down by about 40% immediately, and crashes go down by 20 to 30%.
Our streets are dangerous. People are driving too fast. They're going through red lights. They're going through stop signs.
University District Councilman Rashid Wyatt has led the charge in Buffalo following an unprecedented spike in hit and runs.
There's a lot of concern, not just in the University District, but throughout the city. So I'm hoping that my colleagues will hear from the people. People will come out and really speak from their heart.
One thing the Rochester mayor brought up that she thought was unfair about their program is that it was targeting people in certain parts of the city. That's why she ultimately cut the program.
Right.
And how do you say that wouldn't happen here?
I think before, when these things have happened, there was no community input. There was no conversation. Now we're having dialogue. We're having conversation. How do we make this so that it's fair throughout the city of Buffalo and just not targeted to one community?
Now, most cities issue tickets for $50 to the owners of the vehicles that run the red lights.
And the cameras don't record drivers, right?
No. No, they work a lot like, say, a parking ticket would. They just get a image of the vehicle and the license plate and then in the mail. Councilman Wyatt was quick to say he doesn't think this is necessarily a forever thing for Buffalo. Maybe use them for a few years, cut down on the crashes. He has also talked about how the recent spike in hit and runs has led him to consider these cameras again.
Interesting. Well, if you would like to weigh in on this, there's a hearing today at 11 this morning in council chambers. So we would love to know what you think of the red light cameras. Would you support them in Buffalo? Share your comments with us. We're at News 4 Buffalo on Facebook and Twitter. And